January 1, Tuesday, Solemnity of Mary, the Holy Mother of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in their heart. Then the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord. Mary, Mother of God and Queen of Peace. Today's solemnity honors Mary as Mother of God or Theotokos, the God-bearer. The Christian world celebrates the entry of God into human history by way of the incarnation of Jesus Christ through Mary. Paul declares, "When the fullness of time had come, God sent His Son, born of a woman, so that we might receive adoption." The Virgin Mary conceives Jesus by the Holy Spirit. As a consequence, we are made children of God by adoption. As proof that you are children, God sent the Spirit of His Son into our hearts, crying out, "Abba, Father." So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. Mary carried the greatest gift of God for humanity: Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace. Blessed Pope Paul VI declared January 1 as World Day of Peace. Pope Francis referred to his predecessors in his message of peace for the new year of 2017. Peace is the only true direction of human progress, and not the tensions caused by ambitious nationalisms, nor conquests by violence, nor oppressions which serve as a mainstay for a false civil order. He warned of the danger of believing that international controversies cannot be resolved by the ways of reason, that is, by negotiations founded on law, justice, and equity, but only by means of deterrent and murderous forces. Instead, citing the encyclical Pacem in Terris of his predecessor Pope St. John XIII, he extolled the sense of love of peace founded upon truth, justice, freedom, and love. Reconciliation, the way to peace. Starting from the basic premise that all men are brothers, Pope Paul VI writes, "Peace must be produced. Peace must be invented. It must be created through an ever-watchful disposition, with a will ever fresh and untiring. Peace can be neither passive nor oppressive. It must be inventive, preventive, and operative. Peace must be born of mutual trust between the nations rather than imposed on them through fear of one another's weapons. It does them no good to work at building peace so as long as feelings of hostility, contempt, and distrust, as well as racial hatred and unbending ideologies, continue to divide men and place them in opposing camps. Peace can be achieved by non-violence. Non-violence is sometimes taken to mean surrender, lack of involvement, and passivity. But this is not the case." Pope St. John Paul II, reflecting on the events of 1989 in his 1991 encyclical Centesimus Annus, highlighted the fact that momentous change in the lives of people, nations, and states had come about by means of peaceful protest using only the weapons of truth and justice. Further, he wished, "May people learn to fight for justice without violence, renouncing class struggle in their internal disputes and war in an international ones."